Hey, what's up guys, welcome to Lara Tips. In today's video, I'll be showing you a very useful tip by which you don't have to create a static boot method whenever you want to tap into the boot method of the model. So let me show you that by an example. Here in the database, I have this users table and here I have UUID column. And whenever you are creating a user, you want this UUID field to be automatically filled. Then by default, you will obviously create a boot method in this user model, this static boot method, and you'll call this parent boot and call this static creating model, and you will call this model UUID str UUID to string. This will create a UUID and assign it to the model UUID column. And whenever you are creating a model, this thing will be attached and it will be saved to the database. So let me show you first this. Let me just comment this out first. And if I just save it, then you will get an error. The UUID field doesn't have a default value. But if I uncomment it and run this, then you will see here true. This data is saved. And if I just reload over here, then you can see here a new data has been added over here. So that is the normal thing how you would do it. But let's say you want this feature to be available in other models as well. You also have some other models that have UUID filled over there and you want them to be filled automatically. Then you have to just copy this code and write it over there. And also let's say you decided to create a trait for this whole boot method, then there can be another problem. The boot method of this user doesn't have any extra logic over here. But let's say other model have some extra logic also. Let's say there is something over here in another model. Then you have to again override that boot method on that model also. Whenever you are using a trait that includes the boot method, this static method. But there is another way how you can do it. So let me show you that. Let me just go here inside the app. Let me create traits folder and here I'll call has UUID trait. I'll generate a has UUID and in this trait you need to create a specific method and it must be public static function and it must start with boot and the rest thing is the name of this class. So we'll write here has UUID like this and the return type will be void. Now whatever you write over here that will be called whenever the model is booting. So let me go here in the user and just copy this code from here and paste it over here and let me just import this illuminate support str over here and now I'll just remove this code from here and at the top I'll just go here and use has UUID like this. Now this thing has been imported over here. And you can use this trait wherever you want and you did not even override the boot method in the model. Now if I come here, let me just uncomment it first, and if I come here and try to save it, then we'll see here the field UUID doesn't have a default value. But if I just uncomment it and come here and reload, then I'll see here true, and if I come here and refresh again, then I'll see a new data and this UUID has been automatically added over here. And using this feature, we can easily add the same functionality in the other models as well. And here I have this sub model, then I'll just copy this and go here and just paste it over here. Then it will automatically assign a UUID to this sub model as well. But make sure that UUID column is present in that SOP table. And let me show you how I knew about this. I was just diving into this Laravel core and I found out this. So here, I'll go here inside this user extends authenticable. And here, I'll go here inside this model. And let me just go back and let me show you here inside the SOP also. And this is also extending the same model, okay? Instead, the user is extending authenticable, which is in turn extending this model. So you can easily go here inside and I'll search for boot method over here and it says boot traits. And if I click here, then we can see here a logic over here. Okay. And I just saw this method over here, boot and the class name. Here it is finding all the traits that current model is using. And here it is prefixing boot in that class name. the name of the trait. And it is saying here if this method exists on the class. So in the current class or the current trait, if this method exists, boot and the class name. And we have this has UID trait and the boot and the class name, the name of the class, and this part should be same. So if that exists, then it will call that method on that class. And let me show you this. Okay, let me just comment everything over here. And whenever I create a new user, then it will go here inside. So I'll just do DD over here and I'll say class and method like this. And if I just reload, then you can see here the trait, the model name is over here, and this boot has UID is present over here. And also the name of the trait also, I'll just dump it over here like this. And just reload, then you can see here the trait that we have created. Since the specification of that trait matched this if condition, then it went inside it. And this thing is calling that method on the class. So this method is being called on this trait. So let me show you that also. I'll go here inside the UUID, and here I'll just do DD123. And if this method is being called on this trait, then we will reach this DD. I'll reload here, then we can see here this DD, which means that whenever we are instantiating a new user model or finding that user, then this boot has UID method is automatically called and it is registered. And because of that, it is listening to the creating event of the model, and this UUID is applied to the UUID column of the model, and whenever we save it, then it is saved to the database.